Morning students. So today, next system, that is circulatory system of cockroach. Yesterday we have completed digestive system of cockroach. Next, circulatory system of cockroach. So circulatory system of cockroach is open type of circulatory system. It is open type. Open type of circulatory system without blood vessels. So cavities are only present inside the body. There is a cavity, and in this cavity, body fluids like blood is flowing very freely. It is not flowing through the blood vessels due to the absence of the blood vessels. Blood vessels are poorly developed. That's why blood is present in the pre-cavity. And it is called open type of circulatory system. Okay. Mainly the circulatory system functions. What are the functions of circulatory system? The transfer the digestive food materials to various parts of the body. It also transfer the hormones. Okay. Then transfer the phagocytic cells. Then eliminate the nitrogenous waste materials which are collected from the body parts, send it to the excretory organs for their elimination. Okay. So here, there is no respiratory pigment in the cockroach blood. There is no respiratory pigment, hemoglobin. That's why the blood of cockroach is white in color. Due to the absence of the respiratory pigment. Then what are the components present in the circulatory system of cockroach? In the circulatory system of cockroach, it consists mainly of three parts, which are called hemocele. First one is hemocele, second one is heart. Hemocele, heart, and blood. Hemocele, heart, and blood are the three parts present in the circulatory system of cockroach. So, first one, hemocele. The body cavity of the cockroach. The body cavity of cockroach is called hemocele. So total inside the body there is a cavity which is called hemocele. This hemocele is filled with hemolymph or blood. And it is a cavity without any blood vessels. The blood is flowing very freely inside this cavity, which is called hemocele. Next, heart. Heart is also present. Then blood. These are the three components present in the circulatory system of cockroach. In that first one, hemocele. So what is hemocele? Hemocele is a body cavity. The body cavity of cockroach is called hemocele because it is filled with hemolymph. So hemocele that divides into the three sinuses by two diaphragms. Sinus means it is a small cavity. This is total hemocele. It is divided into the three sinuses by two diaphragms. Diaphragm is a partition which separates the body cavity of hemocele into three cavities, three sinuses, which are called pericardial sinus. First sinus is called pericardial sinus. Second one is called perivisceral sinus. Third one is called perineural sinus. Three sinuses are there by two diaphragms. So these three sinuses of the pericardial sinus. Next, perivisceral sinus and perineural sinus. Three sinuses are there by two diaphragms. So here diaphragm names are the dorsal diaphragm and the ventral.
sinuses, three sinuses, 1, 2, 3. Okay, first sinus is called pericardial sinus, also called as dorsal sinus. Pericardial sinus is also called as dorsal sinus. Dorsal sinus, perivisceral sinus. Perivisceral sinus, it is also called as medial sinus. Then perineural sinus, it is also called as ventral sinus. Okay, this one is the ventral sinus. Pericardial, perivisceral, perineural or ventral sinus. Cross section, pericardial sinus. Where the pericardial sinus is present? Just below the tuber. Just below the tuber, there is pericardial sinus. Then perivisceral sinus, in the middle of the body. Then perineural sinus, just above the sternum. Above the sternum, perineural sinus. So how many sinuses are present here? Three sinuses are present. Okay, right, two diaphragms partitions that divide the body cavity into three sinuses. But pericardial, perivisceral, perineural sinus, three sinuses. Then pericardial sinus, where the pericardial sinus is present, in this part, this cavity is called pericardial sinus. Where it is present? Just below the tuber and above the dorsal diaphragm. Below the tuber, above the dorsal diaphragm, there is a sinus which is called pericardial sinus. Pericardial sinus that encloses heart. Pericardial sinus encloses heart. So heart is present here. Then perivisceral sinus. Perivisceral sinus, visceral organs. Visceral organs. Okay, perivisceral sinus that encloses the visceral organs. Perineural sinus. Perineural sinus that encloses the nerve cord. Nerve cord is present here. This one is the nerve cord. Pericardial sinus encloses the heart. Perivisceral sinus that encloses the visceral organs. Perineural sinus encloses the nerve cord. Okay. And how many diaphragms? Two diaphragms are there. What are they? Dorsal diaphragm, ventral diaphragm. Or pericardial diaphragm, perineural diaphragm. So these two diaphragms that divide the body cavity of cockroach into the three sinuses are pericardial sinus, perivisceral sinus, perineural sinus. Pericardial sinus that encloses heart. Pericardial sinus encloses heart. Perivisceral sinus encloses the visceral organs. Perineural sinus that encloses the nerve cord. Okay, so hemocene, body cavity of cockroach. And also it consists some muscles. It also, hemocene also consists some muscles which are called alary muscles. Alary muscles. Alary muscles are present. Okay, so these are the alary muscles. Alary muscles are the triangular muscles. Triangular muscles. Triangular muscles present like this. Okay, these muscles are called alary muscles, which are triangular in shape. Their broad bases, they have two ends. Broad base pointed end. Their broad bases are attached to the dorsal diaphragm. Okay, this one is the dorsal diaphragm. Their broad bases are attached to the dorsal diaphragm. Their pointed ends are attached to the tuber. Their pointed ends are attached to the tuber. Broad bases are attached to the dorsal diaphragm. Their pointed ends are attached to the tuber. So this is one muscle like this. 12 pairs of alary muscles are present. 12 pairs of alary muscles are present in the hemocoel of cockroach. Okay, so triangular muscles are present in the hemocoel of cockroach, which are present in lateral sides. Okay, lateral sides of the cockroach body cavity, there are 12 pairs of triangular muscles called alary muscles. Alary muscles are helping in the transportation, like circulation of blood, flow of blood, circulation of blood. Total 12 pairs of alary muscles are present. What is the shape of the alary muscle? It is triangular in shape. And their broad bases are attached to the dorsal diaphragm. Their pointed ends are attached to the tuber. Okay, alary muscles. So first part which is present in the circulatory system of cockroach, that is hemocoel. Okay, hemocoel. Body cavity of cockroach is called hemocoel. It has three sinuses. Okay, it has three sinuses.
guarded with the walls. These openings are guarded with the walls. Valvular openings which allow the flow of blood in one direction. They allow the flow of blood in one direction. Valvular openings. Valvular pores are present on the diaphragms. So two diaphragms are there which are called dorsal diaphragm and ventral diaphragm. Two diaphragms that divide the body cavity into three sinuses. Pericardial, perivisceral and perineural sinus. Next, second one is the heart. Heart of cockroach. Second one, heart of cockroach. So heart of cockroach, it is present below the turgor, below the turgor, just below the turgor. So this one is the turgor, dorsal plate. Just below the turgor, under the mid dorsal line. Dorsal side in the middle. Mid dorsal line. One tubular heart is present. Tubular tube like heart is present, which consists of 13 chambers. 13 chambers. Here only one heart, but 13 chambers are present, not 13 hearts. Only one heart, single heart, but it has 13 chambers. In the human heart, 4 chambers are present. Humans having one heart, having 4 chambers. Same like that. In the cockroach also, one heart is present, it has 13 chambers, 13 chambered heart is present. Okay, and each chamber is opening into the previous chamber. For example, here 13 chamber, this one is the 13 chamber. This 13 chamber is opening into the 12th chamber. Then 12th chamber is opening into the 11th one. 11th one is opening into 10th one. 10th one is opening into 9th one. Like that, the last chambers are opening into the previous chambers. Last chambers are opening into previous chambers. The 13th chamber, posterior side is closed. Posterior side, 13th chamber is closed. Anterior side, it is opening into 12th one. Then 12th one is opening into 11th. 11th is opening into 10th. Like that, first chamber. The first chamber of the heart is opening into one blood vessel, which is called aorta. Okay, it is called aorta. Aorta is a blood vessel. Aorta is a blood vessel. Anterior aorta is a blood vessel. Which the first chamber is opening into this aorta. Aorta is opening into head sinus. So one more sinus is present in the head, which is called head sinus. One more sinus is present in the head. Thorax and abdomen, three sinuses are present. What are they? Pericardial sinus, perivisceral sinus, perineural sinus. Three sinuses are present in the thorax and abdomen. In the head, one more sinus is present, which is called head sinus. Okay, heart is actually present in the thorax and abdomen below the turgor, but it is opening into the head sinus through one blood vessel, which is called aorta. Aorta is a small blood vessel which connects the first chamber of the heart with the head sinus. Okay, first chamber of the heart with the head sinus. And each chamber of the heart except last chamber. So this is the heart chamber. Heart chambers. For example, this is 13th one, 13th chamber, posterior side it is closed. Anterior side it is opening into the 12th chamber. 12th chamber is opening into 11th chamber. Okay, here each chamber of the heart except 13th chamber, posterior side of the each chamber of the heart, it has one pair of openings. It has one pair of openings which are called ostia. These openings are called ostia.
13 chamber is opening into 12 chamber. Again, 13 chamber is opening into 12 chamber. 12 chamber is opening into 11 chamber. Then each chamber of the heart except the 13th one means starting from 12 chamber. Starting from 12 chamber, it has one pair of openings which are called ostia. What is the function of ostia? Ostia that allow the flow of blood from the pericardial sinus into the heart. Okay, pericardial sinus into the heart. Here, the blood which is present in the pericardial sinus, it is transported into the heart through these openings which are called ostia. Okay, how many pairs of ostia present? 12 pairs of ostia present. Each chamber that consists one pair of ostia. Except the 13th chamber, except last chamber, because last chamber posterior side it is closed. It is opening into anteriorly 12th chamber. The junction between the 12th and 13th chamber, it has one pair of openings which are called ostia, which allow the flow of blood from the pericardial sinus into the heart. Okay, in the heart flow of blood from posterior to anterior side. 13 to 12, 12 to 11, 11 to 10, like that, first chamber to aorta, aorta into the head sinus. Blood flows into the head sinus. Okay, posterior to anterior side, that is flowing in the heart, the chambers of the cartilage. Okay, second one, heart. Where the heart is present? Heart is tubular heart, present just below the chest and present on the mid-dorsal line. And 13 chambers are present in the heart of the approach. Each chamber is opening into previous chamber. 13 is opening into 12, 12 is opening into 11. In each chamber of the heart, that has one pair of openings. What are they? Ostia. Except the 13th chamber. Except the 13th chamber, remaining all the chambers that consist ostia. The first chamber is opening into one blood vessel which is called aorta. Aorta is opening into the head sinus. Heart of cockroach, and heart of cockroach is neurogenic heart. Neurogenic heart. Neurogenic heart, it control and coordinate, like it contract and relax due to the nerve stimulus. Nerve stimulus. So stimulus that is required for the contraction or starting of the heartbeat. Our heart is myogenic heart. Impulses are not required for the contraction of the heart muscles in the human beings. Myogenic heart. But in the cockroach, it is neurogenic heart. Neurogenic heart means so impulses are required. Means that messages that should come from the CNS or from the brain. So the messages which are coming from the brain, the messages are impulses only that can start the heartbeat of the cockroach. That can contract and relax by the messages which are coming from the CNS. So it is called neurogenic heart. Heart of cockroach is called a neurogenic heart. Second part in the circulatory system. The third part in the circulatory system, hemolymph or blood. Third one, hemolymph or blood. Hemolymph, blood. The blood of cockroach, it is white in color due to the absence of respiratory pigment is absent. Respiratory pigment is absent. Where the blood is flowing? Blood is flowing in the hemocele cavity, body cavity, total body cavity that consists the blood. Are hemolymph. Total visceral organs are water. Total visceral organs, for example, alimentary canal. Alimentary canal is freely present in the body fluids like blood. So, blood, components of the blood. Components of the blood, it consists plasma. It has plasma and blood cells. approach blood. Only WBC are present, which are phagocytic cells. Which are phagocytic cells? This WBC are the phagocytic cells. Phagocyte cells that kill the microorganism, engulf the microorganism. Whenever the microorganism enters into the body, so phagocytic cells that kill the microorganism, engulf the microorganism, undigested. Phagocytic in nature. Okay, blood cells only WBCs are present and they are in phagocytic nature. Then respiratory pigment is absent. Due to the absence of the respiratory pigment, it is not involving, it is not playing any role in the transportation of the oxygen and carbon dioxide. Okay, it is not involving in the transportation of the oxygen and carbon dioxide. Then what are the functions of the blood? Except transportation of the oxygen and carbon dioxide, other functions of the blood. What are the functions of blood? Okay, what are the functions of blood? First function of the blood, it collect the digested food from alimentary canal. This one is alimentary canal. So food materials are digested in the alimentary canal. The digested food materials which are present in the alimentary canal are collected by the blood and sent into other parts of the body. These are the organs. First function. Okay, so transportation of the digested food to various parts of the body. First function. Second function is it transports phagocytic cells to the place where the infection is occurring. For example, an injury is occurred in the head. Microorganisms are enters into the head. Okay, through that injury. So phagocytic cells are present in somewhere other part of the body, like present in the thorax or in the abdomen. The phagocytic cells which are present in the thorax and abdomen, they are carried towards, they are transported towards the head, towards the injury, towards the microbial, towards the that where the microbes are entering into the body. So through this blood only. Blood that transfer the phagocytic cells to the place where the infection is occurring. If the infection is occurring in the leg, phagocytic cells are present in the head. So from the head, phagocytic cells are reaches, they are transported near the leg. So transportation of the phagocytic cells towards the injury. That is the second function. Third function is the it collects nitrogenous waste and send it to the excretory organs. It send it to the excretory organs. What are functions of functions of the blood of cockroach? First function, it collect the digested food materials from the alimentary canal, send it to rest of the body. Second function, it transfer the phagocytic cells to the place where the infection is occurring. Third one, it collect the nitrogenous waste from various parts of the body and send it to the excretory organs for their elimination. For elimination, nitrogenous waste material like uric acid is collected from various parts of the body, sent into the mucosal tubules for their elimination. That is the third function. Fourth function is the it also transport hormones to the target organs. Hormones are the chemical messengers, chemicals which are releasing from the endocrine glands. So the chemicals which are releasing from the endocrine glands are transported to the target organs through this blood only. Okay, through this blood. So that hormones are transported to the target organs. These are the most important functions of the blood of cockroach. What is the first function? So collection of the digested food materials and send it to various parts of the body. cells to the place where the infection is occur. Then collect the nitrogenous waste materials, send it to the excretory organs for their elimination, and also transport the hormones to the target organs. Third one, which is called blood. So three parts are present in the cardiac circulatory system. It is open type. First one, eosinophil, body cavity of cockroach. Second one, heart. Third one, blood. Okay. Next, transportation of the blood. Transportation of blood. How the blood is transported in different sinuses. Okay. No? Circulation of blood. How the blood is transferred? How the blood is transferred in different sinuses? We know that three sinuses are there in the thorax and abdomen: dorsal sinus, medial sinus, ventral sinus, and one more sinus is present in the head. These are separated by the diaphragms: dorsal diaphragm, ventral diaphragm. Then our emergencies are also present. We discussed all this. Next, how the blood is transported between these sinuses. First, where the blood is present, the blood is present in the perivisceral sinus and perineural sinus. The blood which is present in the perineural and perivisceral sinus. Perivisceral sinus. The blood which is present in the perineural and perivisceral sinus. That is transported into the pericardial sinus. It is transported into the pericardial sinus. How that blood is transported from these two sinuses into the pericardial sinus? Here, what happens? Alari muscles are triangular muscles which are attached. Their broad bases are attached to the dorsal diaphragm. Their point plates are attached to the turbine. Due to the contraction of the alari muscles, the dorsal diaphragm pulled down. Okay. Due to the contraction of alari muscles, dorsal diaphragm pulled down. That's why here the cavity of the perivisceral and perineural sinuses decreases. Pressure is increases. And cavity of pericardial sinuses decreases. That's why the blood which is present in the perivisceral and perineural sinus is transported into the pericardial sinus through valvular pores. Already we discussed pores are present. Through this valvular pores, the blood is transported from perivisceral and perineural sinus into the pericardial sinus. Okay, so this is first stage in the transportation of the blood, circulation of the blood. In the next stage, what happens in the first stage? Due to the contraction of alari muscles, the dorsal diaphragm pulled down. So the blood which is present in the perivisceral and perineural sinus is transporting into pericardial sinus through the valvular openings. Next, due to the relaxation of the alari muscles are relaxed. It comes to normal position. Alari muscle comes to normal position. So dorsal diaphragm also, it comes to normal position. Dorsal diaphragm, so before that it pulled down. Due to the contraction of alari muscles, it's pulled down. Due to the relaxation of the alari muscles, comes to normal position. Okay, it comes to normal position. That's why the pressure is increasing in the pericardial sinus. So the blood which is present in the pericardial sinus is transporting into the heart. Through the ostia. So we already discussed ostia are the small openings which are present the lateral sides of the each heart chamber. So this is pericardial sinus. The blood which is present in the pericardial sinus is transported into the heart through the ostia due to the relaxation of the
Then in the heart, the blood is flowing from posterior to anterior side. Posterior to anterior side, 13 to 12, 12 to 11, 11 to 10, like that. First chamber. Then it is transported from first chamber into the aorta. Aorta. Heart, heart. From the heart, it is transported into aorta. Then from the aorta, it is transported into the head sinus. It is transported into the head sinus. Heart, first chamber, aorta, aorta into the head sinus. Again from the head sinus, it is transported into the perineural and perivisceral sinus. This is circulation. How the blood is transported in four cavities, four sinuses, total four cavities are present. Thorax and abdomen, three cavities are present, three sinuses are present. In the head, one cavity is present. How the blood is flowing? First peri, visceral and perineural sinus. Due to the contraction of alveoli muscles, the blood which is present in the perivisceral sinus is transporting into pericardial sinus. Then due to the relaxation of the alveoli muscles, the blood from the pericardial sinus into heart through the ostium. Then is the heart from posterior to anterior side. Then from first chamber into aorta, aorta into head sinus. Again from the head sinus into the perivisceral and perineural sinus. Okay. Perineural, perivisceral sinus into pericardial sinus due to the contraction. Due to the contraction of alveoli muscles. Due to the contraction of alveoli muscles. Then pericardial sinus into heart due to the relaxation. Relaxation of alveoli muscles. Relaxation of alveoli muscles. Contraction of alveoli muscles from perineural, perivisceral into pericardial. Relaxation of alveoli muscles, pericardial into the heart. In the heart, posterior to anterior chamber. So this is transportation of the blood, circulation of the blood in the cockroach. It is a sequence. Okay? Thank you.